Kerala has been the most successful example in India of tackling this coronavirus. In fact, your work has been recognized by experts all over the world and by WHO publicly. Many, many congratulations. Looking back with the experience and knowledge you now have, can you identify, say, the most important steps that were responsible for Kerala's success stories and that others could perhaps learn from all across the world?
At the outset, let me express my gratitude to the kind words of congratulations on behalf of the people of Kerala. We have been able to effectively resist the onslaught of COVID-19, primarily because of three factors. The most important one among these three is the robust public health care system that has been strengthened by the active intervention of the state in the field of health and public care. The second one is the active and positive cooperation of the people of Kerala, who, with a higher level of awareness and social consciousness, strictly adhered to the guidelines that were issued by the government from time to time. The third one is the state's early preparedness, which include focused healthcare interventions, effective lockdown measures, special economic package announced well in advance, timely assistance for migrant laborers, and the decentralized initiatives taken through the local self-governments.
Yep, sir, but as you know, I'm nobody to tell you, the war is not over yet. So what are your main worries now looking ahead?
The battle is won. The war too is to be fought and won. We cannot rest on our accomplishments and let our guard down. Till every positive patient is cured and everyone under quarantine completes their observation period without any complication, we cannot assume to be in safe territory. Accordingly, to the opinion of certain sections of scientific community, COVID-19 is here to stay. If it is so, we have to learn to live with it. As you know, people cannot be locked up forever. Whatever be the reason, relaxation at least for the extent of ensuring livelihood is inevitable. As you are aware, there is an influx of returnee migrants, not only from other states, but from abroad too. Despite the anxiety some sections express, we have to receive them and rehabilitate properly, as they are the ones who toil to keep us going and strengthen the foreign exchange reserve of our nation. Thirdly, we have to tide over the economic crisis that was the direct result of this pandemic. Till now, the total economic loss due to the lockdown in our state is roughly estimated at rupees 80,000 crore. This has happened close on the heels of the two successive floods, which caused a heavy loss of more than rupees 50,000 crore for the state.
Now that you're accepting returning international travelers and interstate movement, people coming into Kerala, almost all the new COVID cases are coming from people outside Kerala, internationally or internally. How are you going to handle this new influx of COVID-19 cases?
We are well equipped to face the situation emerging due to the incoming of returnees. Sufficient institutional quarantine facilities have been prepared. Till date, 2 lakhs bath attached rooms have been readied. All items needed for the personal use of those under quarantine are being provided. Food is being arranged through community kitchens. For those who want to remain in quarantine at their own expenses, rooms have been prepared at hotels and resorts. If the situation further worsens, quarantine alone will not do. Hospitalization too will be required. In the 1,296 government hospitals in the state, we have 49,000 702 beds. Hospitals are equipped with 1,369 ICU beds and 1,000 ventilators as well. 81,904 beds are available in 866 private hospitals. There are 6,059 ICU beds and 1,578 ventilators in them. 207 government hospitals have been prepared to treat those with symptoms. If the number of positive cases increases, 27 hospitals can be converted into exclusive COVID-19 care centers. 125 private hospitals have been readied to be utilized if required. We are prepared to face any eventuality.